trying to get some of my dog's hair off me, man. I got so my dog sheds so much, it's insane. Hey, what's going on, everybody? Welcome back to my channel. My name is Jacob Restituto. I'm a musician from Northport, New York, and welcome back to another Taylor Swift reaction. We're going to be breaking down, talking about, and analyzing all her different the aspects of these songs that she's put on her new album. It's crazy that she's released a new album actually 6 months after her other full-length album. I appreciate that. I think that that is cool. I think that you know, artists so often get caught in this, like, oh, I gotta release an album this every 2 years, every this, and you gotta, like, break, get out of that and, like, break the mold and just do what you want. Like, I don't like the rules that the music industry has created, so I like that she did that, and she's just doing what she wants. Just a note, I find the album, the cover very interesting, just of her hair backwards. It's just, I find it very, like, it definitely catches your eye, but it's just very interesting. But since we're starting off, we're going to be doing Willow today, so I hope you guys enjoy that. If you want to get extra access, if you want to get early access to any of this stuff, we have a Patreon. You can check out the Patreon, a bunch of different options for you if you want to check that out. If you want to check out my music, it's Jacob Restituto. And if you want to text me, two different numbers, international WhatsApp, regular text message number. Let's see what we got. This is Willow by Taylor Swift. Had a whole bunch of requests to do this, actually. So you can hear right off the bat, by the way, if you're new to the channel, I mainly talk about the music, the production, and how they likely made it to help you guys like understand it a little bit more. It sounds like we have stereo recorded acoustic guitars and then another instrument, like plucked instrument, probably an acoustic guitar right in the center at least. Very warm sounding on the left and right here and very bright in the center. Like the water when your ship rolled in. Ton of rhythms going on, especially now that introducing the piano. These a whole bunch of count like counter counter rhythms. And if it was an open shut case, I never would have known from the look on your face. Lost in your current like a priceless wine. Interesting lyric right there. Lost in the current like a priceless wine. It's not what you'd expect her to say. I also find it interesting, like they're very clean, very dry sounding vocals. When I talk about dry, it's not in like sense of boring. It's actually when we re-record music, we talk about effects in dry and wet. The wet signal or the wet sound is the affected sound. So if you have reverb or echo or chorus or compressor or anything like that added, that you're hearing the wet sound. If you don't have anything, or the original recording is the dry sound. Or the wet signal, dry signal. And what we're hearing is a very like dry sounding vocal, not a ton of reverb, not a ton of effects, it's just very clean and crisp, which contrasts on the end, the instruments, because the instruments, they don't have a ton of reverb or echo or anything, but it almost sounds like they have like a sort of echo based on the way they're being recorded. There's a ton of rhythm going on, a ton of different melodies, which create this almost echo atmosphere, contrasting her very clean and direct. I guess the difference in what I'm trying to say is it's not so direct, the instruments, because there's a whole bunch of things going on. It's kind of like this big atmosphere, and then very direct vocals. The more that you say, the less I know. You can hear, though, if I rewind that, actually, when she says, whenever you say, that whole part, you can hear the reverb that's on there, so it's not a completely dry vocal, and most artists would never actually just put up dry vocals. But comparing to the rest of the sound. But what's cool is you hear the piano matching the melody right there. Yes, I know, whatever you stray, that's cool. I follow. I'm begging for you to take my hand, wreck my plans, that's my man. Really, really low harmonies, and you can hear it. So there's definitely layered vocals kind of fattening it up, giving this kind of air. She's also singing in an airy voice as opposed to her full voice. But then there's also, you can at least hear it in the right ear, some layered harmonies going on. Life was a willow and it bent right to your wind. Head on the pillow, I could feel you sneaking in. As if you were a mythical thing. Really, really fat kick drum coming in here, man. Like, seriously fat. Like you were a trophy or a champion ring. There was one prize I'd cheat to win.
You
hear that, it's like palm muted electric guitar coming in the left ear? Very clean sounding, slight distortion.
That's my man. You know that my train could take you home.
you hear that release on that reverb. Listen to what she says, man. That's my man. Nice release on that. Life was a willow and it bent right to your window. They count me out time and time again. Life was a willow and it bent right to your window. Nice strings coming in. So it's cool how like she has this in this whole song so far, like very, very descriptive sounds, very I wouldn't even say almost dated sounds, like talking about like wine, like these like very like I guess mature kind of things, I guess you would consider. I don't know the best way to say it, but like, you know, it almost gives you very reminiscent trains and wine. It almost put like old world kind of sounds. And then she talks about the 90s trend. It's like a total like it's very different than what you'd expect. Wait for the signal and I'll meet you after dark. I appreciate though, by the way, that she's not she was able to make the change from going to like doing stuff like, you know, her Red album, which is very like I guess pop stuff, you know, but or I don't remember all the names actually of the albums, but like the ones that had or what songs were on the albums, but like 22 and like Knew You Were Trouble, like that very like pop kind of sound, to then the very like almost alternative pop with the Reputation album, and now she's doing whatever she wants, this kind of folk stuff, which is kind of cool. Like, I appreciate that she's not putting herself in a box. Now this is an open shut case. I guess I should have known from the look on your face. Every beat and switch was a work of art. Layered vocals again. The more that you say, the less I know. Interesting to see how she plays this live, because a whole bunch of these actually songs aren't these. It's more. It actually reminds me very much of like almost a John Mayer kind of feel, where especially his earlier stuff, like it was just kind of chill music, or like Iron and Wine, you know that band. Very just chill listening music. Great storylines though, but there's not a ton of like songs that are making you like jump out of your seats and clap and dance and stuff. It's more of this kind of chill, have a glass of wine, or you know, like something like that kind of feel to it, which John Mayer definitely had that feeling, is like acoustic kind of sounds, which is ironic actually being the fact that they did. Very cool. All right, well, I hope you guys enjoyed that. As always, you can leave a comment. You can text me. Two different numbers, international WhatsApp, regular text message number. Very cool. Like I said, Taylor Swift to release the two different albums so close to each other. Kind of similar sounds to them, but also different at the same time. Always one of the best storytellers. Taylor Swift has a very distinct writing style and very distinct, great storytelling ability. So you can text me if you want to check out the Patreon. A couple of different options on there. If you want to check out my music, it means a lot to me. And I'll see you guys later. Peace out.